Right, I mean, actually, to be very honest, we never planned for it. Right, you know, about two and a half years ago, we were just pivoting from a you know, voice over IP business, and you know, wanted to get into gaming. Right, and you know, we just thought that the niche of building games for India and the reimagining games that have existed forever, you know, would be something that, you know, would interest our, you know, the user base, and it just happened, right? When, you know, one guy downloaded it, he liked it, so he just, you know, got, showed it to his friends, so he, you know, the friends came in, and it's just been a viral story after that. So to be very honest, we've never really planned for the growth that we got. At the end, since we were a very strong technology company, we were able to really manage and
you're
support.
You're saying that how many 15 lakh people play your games concurrently and release some?
Half a million, 5 lakh.
Half a million, 5 lakh. Right. And you have how many downloads?
We've had, we have upwards of 30 million registered users on Teenpatti.
Okay.
Right, upwards of, you know, 15 million downloads from the Google Play Store. You know, that's just Teenpatti. We also have Rummy, which has crossed, you know, a million downloads on Google Play Store in entirety, has crossed 5 million downloads.
Right.
So I mean, we've been the company that has actually kind of, you know, been able to take a contrary stand on that, right? I mean, we've been the top grossing game in India for all of 2014, right? And the top grossing game basically means when you know, it's the title given to a game which has the highest revenue, direct revenue from the users, right? Users actually pay for currency inside our games, and we've actually, you know, been very different from that, in that sense, from the likes of Angry Birds.
Right.
We've actually been able to monetize our users very, very well.
Right.
So amongst all games in the world, right, our games have been able to get extract the most revenue from Indian users.
Right. Is it because you have an older demographic of users? You mentioned somewhere inside.
I think it's
like
more
it's
relevant content.
24 and also 50 plus.
Right. It's more relevant content.
And also it's gambling and casino. That you
it's casino, definitely.
Right.
Right. So casino genre globally is more monetizable than, you know, indirect revenue than arcade.
Right.
Up until Candy Crush came in and you know, proved us otherwise.
Right.
Right. Now Candy Crush is definitely, you know, in the arcade category and very, very highly monetized, you know, platform.
Right.
So I mean, we're still very young, right? I mean, the first time I thought about making games was like 2 years ago, right? And at that time I had no idea how games were built. You know, I mean, we were thinking of it as a more as an app business where, you know, a bunch of developers start coming in and build games. Now we've started thinking of it more as entertainment, more as movie business, more about transitions, how, you know, the user interface needs to be built and how the transitions happen, right? So we're definitely maturing in that space, and you know, as I mentioned, you know, in my panel discussion as well, you know, I think we're right now only as Octro, we're only in the cards and casino genre. We would love to get into other genres.
Okay.